Good afternoon, and welcome to Festival del Sole's annual community concert at the Lincoln Theater. I'm Charles Letourneau, executive producer of Festival del Sole, and it is such a pleasure to welcome so many of you here today. This free presentation of Angel Heart is made possible by the generosity of Jan Schrem and Maria Minetti Schrem, and other supporters of Festival del Sole's community access and arts education programs. Today's concert will be presented without an intermission, and with so many children in the audience, we wanted to make sure to tell you that it is okay to take a bathroom break and come back into the theater if necessary. So now, please take a moment to turn off your cell phones and enjoy the concert. Thank you.
There. Do you hear it? There's a whispering of wings in the silence of the night. They're coming. With feathers as white as snow and faces as bright as the moonlight. Angels. They come to chase the nightmares that gallop through the night and to harvest the light of the stars.
Lost in sleep. my love, and dreams will bring thee clothes of starry wreaths to ring thee. Angel choirs their songs to sing thee all through the night, all through the night.
But look, who is that one? He tumbles from the sky like a young bird. His wings are not much larger than a pigeon's. Oh, now he's upset. He says he's not that young. His name is Ramiel, and he's almost 2,000 years old. He's the angel of love and compassion.
Oh,
Ramiel loves the world of men and beasts. The night is like black velvet under his wings, and he hears a thousand dreamers whispering in their sleep. So many hearts are beating amongst the trees, in the houses, between the hills, and under the waters, shimmering with the light of the stars. So much life, fish and birds and hare, fox, mice and moth. Ramiel touches them with his fingers made from light. He strokes fur and scales and feathers, leaves and bark. Oh, life! He laughs. It's like a dance in the night. What is that sound? So sad. So lonely. So much sadness. Ramiel has heard that love can do that to humans, but he has never seen it before. He He hides in the moonlight and looks at the girl that sits all by herself by the side of a pond. She's young and beautiful, but her heart is broken into a thousand pieces. Angels can't see things like that. Her name is Luna. Ramiel can see that too. Angels see everything, which can be sometimes quite exhausting, especially when it comes to humans. Humans are so much more complicated than fish or birds. Her hair is as dark as the night, and her face is as pale as the moon. Ramiel spills a bit of starlight onto her shoulders and smiles at her when she looks up. An angel's smile is brighter than a thousand stars. Luna's eyes grow wide. Ah, she sees him. Not every human does. Who are you? She whispers. That's quite a silly question, but maybe she's one of those who pretend they don't believe in angels. Ramiel spreads his wings a bit wider to get any doubts out of the way. And Luna feels the sadness in her heart melting like butter in the sun. Ramiel fills the night with laughter and song and rainbows made from starlight. But Luna's heart is still in pieces, and the sadness comes back like a shadow darkening her bright face. Leave me alone, she says. Thank you very much, but you're wasting your time. I'm sure there are others who need your help. crying again. Wipes the tears from her cheeks, but there are too many. They make even his warm fingers feel cold and wet. This is too much pain, even for an angel. It seems like they'll need some magic, as white as its feathers and as old as the ground under the girl's feet. Ramiel looks at the dark hills that rise in the distance. He knows someone who may be able to mend that broken heart as easily as a broken mug. She's slightly grumpy and for sure not an angel, but she knows more about human hearts than he does. And much more about lovesick girls and tears and all that. But it will be a long way.
child of the city.
Luna doesn't look very strong after all her sighing and crying. You should sleep, Ramiel says. He says it in his best commanding angel voice. But Luna won't listen. She just stares at the dark pond as if she wants to drown herself in it the next minute. This will be difficult. Saramiel calls the others, all the angels of the night. They wrap the girl in light, and Ramiel builds her a nest from their feathers because the grass is wet from dew. Is this a dream? Luna whispers. If yes, it's a good one. And I can still drown myself tomorrow. Then she closes her eyes, and the angels fill the night once again with music. witch that can heal broken hearts as easily as broken bones, lives in a house built from raven feathers. She sits on a roof in the shape of a magpie when Ramiel knocks at her door. What is it? She croaks. Then she sees the angel. Oh, well, I'm coming, she says, turning into a very black cat. Who can say no to an angel? Even when it is such a young and foolish one. The witch doesn't look much older than Luna when she takes human shape, but her hair is as white as the angel's wings. She says, pressing her hand onto the girl's chest. This heart won't easily mend. It lost a lot of love. I know only one cure for that. Over the raven feathers that clad her house like a cloak. And out of the wall steps a huge man, as feathery as a bird. His nose is black and curved like a beak, and his eyes are pools of sadness. Luna steps back under the angel's wings, and even Ramiel has to gather all his light around him. There's so much loss in the huge man's face, and so much knowledge about the night side of the world. The angel can hear his heart. It hums a sad, sad song. Mistress, the raven man says, bowing in front of the witch, what is your command? Take the years from her, the witch answers. Make her heart young again, so it can mend. The dark man looks at Luna. And then he looks at the angel. I ask for a gift in return, he says. I want one of your feathers. That's not too bad. Ramiel plucks one out of his left wing. So white, so bright with light. The Ravenman closes his fingers around it with a smile. Then he wraps his feathery arms around Luna. And when he lets go, she's a child again. help you remember yourself, the witch says. We know best who we are when we are very young. Then she turns to the angel. Take her to east, north, and west. Let them sing their lullabies to her, and when she lies down in the south, her heart will be mended. Luna looks at her small hands. She hasn't had such small hands for many years. Shall we fly? Ramiel asks her. Yes, Luna replies with a smile. I think I can. I feel as light as one of your feathers. Dressed in leaves and as slender as a birch tree. Her lullaby is the song of the wind. It reminds Luna of dancing with bare feet in wet grass, of her mother's arms, of the light of the sun, the scent of flowers, and of being young, so young. She falls asleep, angel above her head and the music like dew on her skin. And when she wakes, Ramiel takes her hand, and they head north. Oh, the North. She's all water and withering leaves and frost that makes even the angel shiver. But her lullaby makes Luna forget, and the water's song washes away the last traces of pain that were hiding in the cracks of her heart. Her hair's white with frost when she wakes, and Ramiel warms her with his wings. Then they float westwards on rivers of moonlight, underneath them the dark limbs of the earth. The west will sing his song. West is even bigger than the Raven Man. He's as big as the mountains. He's the spirit of the earth. His lullaby makes Luna's heart as firm and as strong as a drum. And she falls asleep in his hand. Ramya smiles. Even for an angel, it is a very happy smile. He sees that the girl's heart is almost mended. It learned to remember, it learned to forget, and how to be strong. Now it only must dare to love again. And there's no better teacher for that than the South. They just have to follow the scent of its flowers.
The dream.
When the sow sings her lullaby, it covers the night with blossoms. They turn to stars in the sky and drown the earth in roses. And the girl's heart is mended. She smiles in her sleep as she turns back into the beautiful girl that Ramiel saw crying by the pond. The angel feels her smile on his face and in his heart. It is the last hour of the night. It has been a long night. A very long night. Even for an angel.
I told my love in sorrow.